Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Let's take a look at how we can add data to your Svelte component. Over here, I have written a Svelte component which has a heading which says Hello World and an image tag that has a logo for the Svelte logo. What if I want the contents of the header to be dynamic? I want it to come from somewhere that I can define from in my code. Okay, import from somewhere. And how about I want a dynamic image URL for my image tag, right? So that is when you need to write a script tag over here. Script tags in a Svelte components allows you to add logics to your components, add logics and data in your component. So I can come over here and define a content, say, Hello, okay, let me just copy instead of typing it out. Hello world. And I can also have an image URL, which is this one. Let me copy it. Whoops. And so that I can have dynamic contents over here, dynamic data, and I want to apply it to the to my elements over in below. So how do I do that? Well, in Svelte, if you want to use JavaScript expressions in your HTML, you would use curly brackets. Curly brackets. So instead of writing hello world, I can have my curly brackets. And I within the curly brackets, I can write any JavaScript I want. So over here, I can write content. So any variables that you define within a script tag, as long as it's at the top level, then it will be available for your script tag. What I meant by top level is that if I come over here, if I define a function, so I call it function foo, and I define contents over here, hello, by world, then this variables that you define is actually scoped within your function. It's not at the top level. So if I comment this out, then you will say content is not defined. Fair enough. So I have to define it at the top level. Same thing goes for your attributes. I can come over here, remove this, and have a curly brackets. So anything within curly brackets will be able for me to write JavaScript. So I come over here, I say image URL, paste it in, boom! I have a dynamic attributes in my HTML elements. So a few things about this. You can omit if this is just a value for the entire variable will be able for your attributes, you can actually omit the quote sign. Well, it is useful for some people where maybe they are writing HTML, they are used to writing HTML, then you can keep that quote sign. And it's also useful for editors that does not support Svelte. You have that quote sign on, it makes the and you can style. You can select your language as HTML, and then it will syntax highlight. The syntax highlighting will still works fine. So that's one thing. And secondly, if I instead of defining image URL, I'm gonna define as source over here. You see, I'm typing source equals to source. This may be a bit more keystrokes than you type. So we create a shorthand for this. If you have case like this, can actually write this instead. So this curly brackets wrapped with the source is exactly the same as writing source equals source. So if you have a variable that the name of the variable is exactly the same as your attribute name, then you can have this shorthand instead. So in summary, you can write a curly brackets and you can have any JavaScript in there, be it the content or an attribute. And lastly, we've seen how you can write a shorthand for attribute if your variable name is the same as the attribute name. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment down below. And as always, remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.